In Unity, it's possible to process our audio signals with audio effects and shape their timbre, frequency content, or the dynamics of their volume. We can do this by adding audio effects to a group in an audio mixer. In our scene, we have four game objects, each with an audio source which contains a loop of a different element of a musical track. All of these are routed into Audio Mixer 1. Audio Mixer 1 currently has an attenuation effect, which is there by default, on the master channel. If we play our scene, activate Edit in Play Mode, we can adjust the volume of the attenuation effect and thereby control the volume of the master group. Notice that as we adjust the volume, the changes in volume are reflected in the volume parameter in the inspector. It's important to note that when we make changes in play mode, those changes will be saved to the audio mixer asset, unlike changes made to the scene hierarchy, for example, which will be reset when we exit play mode. In order to apply effects processors to the audio signal passing through the master, we can add them from the drop-down menu. We're going to add a low-pass simple effect. The low-pass simple effect is a low-pass filter which allows us to attenuate frequencies above the cutoff frequency. The default is 5,000 Hz. If we play our project, edit in play mode, and adjust the cutoff frequency, can hear that the high frequencies are attenuated. Audio effects are applied sequentially. So in this case, the attenuation effect is going to be applied first, followed by the low-pass simple effect. We'll add a distortion effect and listen to the resulting signal. We can hear that the distortion adds high and mid-range harmonics, which were not previously present in the signal. In this case, the distortion is sequenced after the low-pass simple, so the high frequencies are attenuated, and then new mid and high frequencies are added. If we want to change this order, we can click on the low-pass simple and drag it down so that it now occurs after the distortion in the signal chain, and we can listen to the effect. What we can hear is that as we attenuate the high frequencies using the low pass, it's canceling out the effect of the distortion effect because the distorted signal is being run sequentially through the low pass simple effect. Let's check out another example. Here we have the Nightmares project, which you can download from the Asset Store. And what we've done is we've routed our background music to an audio mixer, to this music group here, and we've added a low-pass filter effect. We've also created two audio mixer snapshots. Audio mixer snapshots allow us to save and recall the settings in the mixer. In the unpause snapshot, the cutoff frequency for the low-pass filter is all the way up at 22,000 Hz. In the paused snapshot, we've pulled it down to 365 Hz. This is going to attenuate the high frequencies and give the music a muffled sound when the paused snapshot is called. The script which controls our pause menu also controls the transition to these snapshots. For more about snapshots and controlling them via script, see the information linked below. Let's check this out and hear how it sounds. Press Escape. And then press Escape again to resume. This is an example of how we can use audio effects processing to convey information to the player about the game state.